last supper, Jesus took his disciples to the Garden of Gethsemane at the Mount of Olives. It was quiet and peaceful there when Jesus started to pray, as he was filled with great sadness and fear. Then Jesus said to his disciples,
"Sit here while I go over there to pray."
Jesus felt sad and afraid, knelt down and prayed.
"Father, I pray of what will happen, but I always do what you ask me to."
Then an angel from heaven appeared to him and strengthened him. And in his anguish, he prayed more earnestly, and sweat was the drops of blood falling to the ground. After praying, Jesus went back to his disciples and found them asleep. He said,
"Wake up! Could you not stay awake with me for such a short time? Get up! The time has come."
While he was still speaking, there came a cloud. The man called Judas, one of the 12 disciples, was leaving them. He came near to Jesus to kiss him, but Jesus said to him,
"Judas, would you betray the Son of Man with a kiss?"
The disciples around Jesus saw what was going to happen. Then Simon Peter, who carried a sword, drew it and wounded him. Cutting off his right ear. The servant's name was Malchus, but Jesus said,
"Put the sword back in its place. Do you think that I will not drink the cup of suffering which the Father has given me?"
Then Jesus touched the man's ear and healed him. The Roman soldiers seized Jesus, led him away, and took him to the house of the high priest. Peter followed at a distance. When those present had lit a fire in the middle of the courtyard and sat down together, Peter sat down among them. A servant girl saw him seated in the firelight and was roasting to him, and said,
"This man was also with him."
But Peter denied it and said,
"Woman, I do not know him."
A short time later, another servant man saw him and said,
"Aren't you one of Jesus' disciples?"
Peter denied it, saying,
"Man, I do not know."
About an hour later, another man insisted,
"Didn't I see you in the garden with him?"
"Man, I do not know what you are talking about."
Again, Peter denied it, and at once the cock crew. Then Peter remembered the word the Lord had spoken to him. "Before the rooster crows today, you will deny me 3 times." He went outside and cried bitterly.
After Jesus was arrested in Gethsemane, he was taken to Pilate, the Roman governor. Pilate wanted to set Jesus free, so he spoke again to the crowd. but they shouted at the top of their voices,
"Crucify him! Crucify him! Crucify him!"
So Pilate agreed to their request and sent Jesus to be whipped. But the people kept shouting as loud as they could for Jesus to be put to death. Finally, Pilate gave in. He freed Barabbas and handed Jesus over for them to do what they wanted with him. Simon, who is strong enough to help Jesus carry the cross. Then, Simon was ordered by the soldiers to carry the cross, because he was struggling to carry the cross. Jesus looked at Simon and quietly whispered, "Thank you," to him. Then they continued on the long road, carrying the cross together.
Running the words Jesus face. Jesus' heart was sweating and blood was running to his eyes, making it very difficult to see. Out of the crowd comes Veronica.
Move
on! A woman who loves Jesus very much, and she makes her way to Jesus to wipe his face. To thank her, he left a picture of his face on her veil. They hammered nails into his hands and feet. Jesus was in a lot He knows that he's going to die. But he looks at the people who have hurt him, and instead of saying bad things to those people, Jesus asks God to forgive them.
Father, forgive these people. They don't know what they're doing.
It was then Jesus was nailed to the cross. He looks at his mother and tells her to take care of others. Even when he's dying, Jesus is thinking of other people.
Jesus dies on the cross. Jesus knew that everything had now been completed, and the end is near. And to fulfill the words of the scripture, he perfectly said, after Jesus had taken the vinegar, he cried out in a loud voice,
"It's accomplished!"
Then Jesus bowed his head and died. Please kneel. When Jesus died, the sky got dark and the ground started to shake. This made some people very scared. They realized that Jesus was innocent and that they had made a big mistake. Jesus has given his life for all of us. It was so unnecessary for Jesus to die this way. He was not a criminal. He had done nothing wrong.